Here I am at Crystal Palace, because we're going to look at Crystal Palace Park, which I'm hoping is right outside the station, that greenery up there. Just going to take my mask off and we can start. Okay, sorted, I think. What we have here is a dinosaur park, a mini farm, which is like a children's zoo, and a big football stadium. The park also has the Crystal Palace remains somewhere. I'm not quite sure where I will find them. And a maze, which I probably won't get to. I seem to remember the palace being up there somewhere, but I'm going to cross the road and just see. I remember the palace being over here somewhere. So I don't know. The stadium is there. The dinosaur park and the mini farm are down there. But let's just go somewhere. Oh, okay. Thank you for visiting. I'm on my way out by the looks of it. Where's the palace? I've been up here lots of times, well, a few times, but my brain is not working today for navigational purposes, it seems. Although I did get to the park and I navigated the tube system.
Gonna wait that fast.
I think there's gonna be a map up here, so let's have a look. hoping to get out of the park, out of the house early, but I'm afraid it's about midday now. But those steps look like part of it. Yeah, it's up there. Okay. And I'm not on the footpath, etc. People around, I wonder if something's going on. That radio mast broadcasts across London. There are some to the north of London as well. This is one of a few that in the south. I think when I was here before, there was not much fencing around. It was all basically wide open space. Must be a few years then. Ancient structure. I'll explain it in a bit. Here we are. These are the remains of the Crystal Palace that the park is named after. used to be known as Penge, this area, but it's Crystal Palace now. The Crystal Palace was built not here, but in Hyde Park for the Great Exhibition of 1851. And then it was moved here afterwards. Just quite a task building it and then moving it, but technology just reached the point of being able to make large sheets of glass that were strong. So they built a giant glass house for the exhibition. And it was here until, well, 1936, I think it burned down. And there have been lots of plans to rebuild it, but nothing's come of it. Sorry about the noise, but you know, humans. I might blot it for the sake of YouTube in case it recognises it or something. Bits of it remain, but not a lot really. As you can see, it was huge. Everybody's doing the wildflower bit these days to try and save the insects and the birds. If you're a hieroglyphics expert, what does it say? Akhenaten? Tutankhamun? I don't know. Say Ramses or something like that, couldn't it? I don't know. How many Egyptian kings do we know? Or pharaohs. Appropriate name for the, or appropriate title for the age of fairy dust, isn't it? Pharaoh? Maybe? Maybe not. Let's go and find some of the other bits. To get here, I got the tube to Highbury and Islington, or the Victoria Line, and then got the overground train from Platform 1, which goes to Crystal Palace about once every half an hour. Luckily, I got there with 3 minutes to spare, but still, I'm here. You can catch the overground at various stations, Canada Water. There's another one on the Jubilee line. It's kind of weird that you have to go outside the park to get to other bits of it. It used to be all one park, but they've sort of adjusted things a bit since I was here before. I think that building might be the old pumping station that used to be around here. I think it's a museum now. If it's not that building, it's one nearby. Football stadium there used to be used for the FA Cup finals, Football Association, that is, meaning soccer. So it's a big stadium and it's in the park. There's like a lot of London parks, this is quite big. Railway station again. Capel Manor College, Crystal Palace Park Centre. Capel Manor Farm entrance, it says, but it doesn't look like much of an entrance at the moment. And it wasn't the entrance even before. But the farm looks like it's been modified quite a lot again since I was here last. It didn't look like this at all. I'll have to visit this place more often. like at least once every 3 or 4 years or something. But it is a long way from where I live. The train from Highbury and Islington to here took me about 43 minutes, I think it was. Oh, some of the farmyard animals. They've made it a lot more natural looking. They used to be in little pens. This is much better. If it's free, I might go in. It may not be open for fairy dust reasons, I don't know. Hello. Oh, we have some llamas here too. Llamas and bees on the thistles. Well, the bee was on the thistle, the llama was on the ground. Looking fairly closed at the moment. There's the football stadium. Looks like you can see a game without paying for a ticket if you're lucky. Of course, you'll probably watch it on TV if it's a serious game. Well, it looks like it might be open, bits of it. I won't go in there, I suppose. We can look at the opening hours. Well, after 3:30, Saturdays, Sundays and bank holidays. I don't remember paying last time, but I'll just go and have a look. to wear a mask. I won't do that. That's the bit I remember. They've extended it a lot. In there are, well, as you've seen, goats and llamas, pot-bellied pigs, tarantulas, lizards and bunnies and stuff like that. Okay, the camera's giving me a bit of a chip today, but for some reason the memory card expired, but maybe I didn't delete stuff from it last time. But I have a spare. I've taken the opportunity to change the battery as well, since it was half done. This is right by the farm. I don't know what point the memory card filled up, but you've just missed a brief look at the farm. There it is, which is open weekends and bank holidays from midday to 3:30 p.m. only. And you have to wear a face mask in there at the moment because of the fairy dust. But look down there. These have been here since 1856, I think. So let's go and have a look.
Up, 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 up. Strong. Push, push, push more. Push, push,
modern bee. In fact, quite a few of them. Because they've been here since 1856, the anatomy is how is true to the science of that time, more or less. I guess. I don't know which ones are which. Maybe the knobbly ones are ankylosaurs, I don't know. Diplodocus. Or maybe a plesiosaur. Yeah. Some sort of ichthyosaur, perhaps. I've had a couple of them, there's one in the background as well, isn't there? Modern ducks and ducklings, or geese and goslings, actually. I can also see a coot, the black and white bird, resting on the plesiosaur, resting beside it. I think it has a chick as well, but hard to see. Yes.
Emma, look at that. Ooh, the crocodiles. Emma, look over there.
Now let me put in the proper sound, because again the camera's giving me trouble. Okay, hold on. Right, okay. I don't know. The only difference with the sound is that for a few minutes there I was not using the binaural mic because it wasn't plugged in. Because I had to unplug it to change the memory card, so there you go, and I didn't plug it back in. I think it was meant to be a Iguanodon. About twice the height of a grown man, I should think. So here we have Teleosaurus, that's the crocodilian thingy. Oh, Megalosaurus, there we go. That's Megalosaurus up there. Hyliosaurus, I think those, that might be one of the knobbly ones. First stegosaur ever found. Some Canada geese, the distant descendants of these critters. There's Iguanodon. He's over there. Pterodactyl, I haven't seen that one. Mosasaurus in the water. That was the ichthyosauroid. 175 to 66 million years ago.
Look at that big dinosaur. You see it?
I think this was an artificial display to display sedimentary rock formations and things like that back in the day. Not really being used now. Well, there used to be a sign on it explaining stuff, but it's not here anymore. Or is this it? Yes, it is. The explanation is hidden and disguised. Interesting. Oh, here we go. There is an explanation in more readable language if you stop the video. Limestone, coal, sandstone. That's what we have. I saw there. Can you see those? Somewhere around here we have Megatherium, Anopoltherium, Anoplotherium, I think we saw some of those under the trees, and Paleotherium, we saw some of those I think. Haven't seen the Megatherium, the giant sloth. Where's that fellow? These are megalo something, I forgot what they are, but megaloceros or something like that. Giant deer. Got damaged horns. Yep. Boating lake. think we're going out of that area now and we'll see what else there is to look at. Have to do without seeing Megatherium perhaps. Don't know where it is. That megaloceros is Irish elk. It may be another name for the same thing. So we didn't see Megatherium or pterodactyl. I think we saw all the rest. You'll have to visit if you want to see them, I guess. Or I'll come back again. Maybe, probably not. Well, this park also has an open air concert venue, which I haven't mentioned, I think. So yes, you can easily spend the best part of a day here, if you like parks. And dinosaurs. Just to point out that some of those critters were not strictly dinosaurs, but they were all prehistoric anyway.
Y también a veces nuestro Timmy.
Just reconnected a bit more of the microphone. I'm not sure what it was doing for the last few minutes, or if this video is rubbish, I'll come back another day. Do it again. Just in case you're wondering, this is sort of mid-July 2021. Children's play school. I don't know what the big white tent is. I think it's a big white tent. Kind of looks like it might be for gardening purposes actually from here. skateboard park as well. Which way? The guy who overtook me earlier is going that way, so I think that's a good sign to go somewhere else. Some people, you just can't shake them. Trespassers will be prosecuted. There's a guy over there. But anyway, I guess this bit is being preserved. I'm kind of angling in the general direction of the maze, but I don't know exactly where it is. Because the park is way more overgrown than it was when I came here before. Back then they used to mow the lawn everywhere. We're coming to the outdoor concert venue, actually. Some bramble in the way. Oops. And some more. Don't think this is the official path somehow, but anyway. Right. It's not looking in good condition, is it? Let's have a look. The audience would sit up there and the concerts would be here. Looks like no more. There's the site of the Crystal Palace. Don't think I'm going to find any maze. Oh, I can see the maze. Now, how's the video doing? It's probably quite long by now. I can't really see on the camera screen, but I think I'll have time to get to the maze. Whether I'll be able to get out again, is it? If I never publish this video, you'll know I never got out again. Bob Marley and the Wailers played their largest UK concert and final London show here, 7th June 1980. Crystal Palace Bowl. And then, by the looks of it, they gave up on it all. Is this a genuine map of the maze? If so, can I figure out how to get through it before I get there? It looks a bit complicated. Where's the way in? No, there is no way in shown on that. Oh, unless the lines are the paths, perhaps. I don't know. It looks a bit difficult. Maze originally dates from about 1870. It's one of the largest mazes in the country. Sometimes known as a tea maze, replanted in 1987. Well, is it even open? I don't know. Let's see. I had a look at this on Google Earth because bits of it were overgrown by trees, I couldn't see how to get through it. So, yeah. Get a bit boring. The escape gate. Oh, is this not the way in? I don't know. Let's go in anyway. Actually, I've just cheated basically, haven't I? Strange, not much of a maze, is it? What happens if I go around here? Hopefully I can come out down there, perhaps, I don't know. Some choices here. I'm going to go this way. More choices. I guess that's not a proper way. I know where I am. Nope. Don't quite feel like I'm in The Shining or something. There's the centre, but when I was in there I couldn't see any other way in other than the escape gate. Mm. would be cheating, wouldn't it? All very strange. I suppose a maze is supposed to be puzzling. Battery could run out within the next 10 minutes. I'll say bye for now, perhaps forever. Just in case. Cheat and walk across there. Oh, I'm here, and so is a mouse, or some sort of field mouse or something. I have found the way out. There we go. Hope you've memorised that for your trip. I might go and find my way back to the café and get some lunch or something. I heard something rustling in the leaves, probably another little mousy fellow. Palace is up there, then the cafe is down here somewhere. There's the football stadium. like a walk through the nice woods or try and take a shortcut. Shortcut time, I think. Past the mysterious blimp thing.